In this video, we are going to have in the same section 4.2 definition, examples and results on linearly dependent and linearly independent set of vectors. Now first we have the definition of linearly dependent vectors. If V is a vector space and if V1, V2 and so on Vn are in B, we say that they are linearly dependent over F. If there exist elements lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda n in F, not all of them are zeros such that the linear combination is zero. We don't have all of them to be zero, but yet the linear combination is zero. So if that is the case, then we call V1, V2 and so on Vn to be linearly dependent. Now a simple example is zero vector. Zero vector is linearly dependent, or if you consider the set singleton zero, it's a linearly dependent set for the reason that if we consider alpha zero, then without alpha being zero, we are getting alpha into that zero vector to be zero. So we have singleton zero to be linearly dependent set, or just say that zero is a linearly dependent vector. Now if you consider the vectors 1 1 0 order triplet, 1 1 0 order triplet, 3 1 3 order triplet, 5 3 3 in R3, they are linearly dependent over R. Now this can be established by considering our AV1 plus BV2 plus CV3 equated to 0. And when we simplify this, these are the equations that we will get, and by solving which we will get B to be equal to minus C and A to be equal to minus 2C. So if we give value for C as 1, then B is minus 1 and A is minus 2. So here without our A, B, C to be 0, we are getting the linear combination to be 0. So this is one way of establishing that these vectors are linearly dependent. Another method is we can consider this is possible if you are given in R3 three vectors, because determinant exists only for a square matrix. So we have the determinant when we evaluate this determinant, if you are getting that to be 0, from that also we can conclude that these vectors are linearly dependent. So another example is if you consider order triplet 1 4 minus 2 minus 2 1 3 and minus 4 11 5, these are linearly dependent over R in R3. So next is linearly independent vectors. When do we say that V1 etc. Vn are linearly independent? So in one way we can say that if they are not linearly dependent, then they are linearly independent. And in other words, we can say that the vectors are linearly independent if the linear combination equated to 0 gives each scalar 0 for all I ranging from 1 to n. That is, the linear combination which is equal to the additive identity present in B, if we have that relation implying each scalar, each one should be 0. So the 0 refers to the additive identity present in B, and this 0 refers to the scalar 0 in F. Now if you consider in R3, this is 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1, the ordered triplet. If you consider these three vectors, they are linearly independent over R, because when we consider again the same method, you can consider A into E1 plus B into E2 plus C into E3 equated to the additive identity in R3, namely order triplet 0, 0, 0, and you can easily have that A to be 0, B to be 0 and C to be 0. Or in other words, we can have the determinant and show that these as first row elements and these as second row elements and these as the third row elements, then the determinant will not be equal to 0. In such case also, we can say that the vectors are linearly independent over R. Now the vectors, if we consider these three vectors, then they are linearly independent over R. Again, there are two methods. One is A into, if we name them as V1, V2, V3, AV1 plus BV2 plus CV3 equal to 0 should give A equal to 0, B equal to 0 and C equal to 0. Otherwise, in R3 with these three vectors. If we form the determinant and when we evaluate that, if we get it to be not equal to 0, then also we can conclude that the vectors are linearly independent. Now one more example, that's from R2. If we consider the vector W1, which is an ordered pair, minus 3, 4, and another vector, say W2, with ordered pair 3, minus 4, and that is W2 stands for this ordered pair, then we can say that this W1, W2 are linearly independent. And one more thing, they lie on the same line. Okay, if we join them, then we can easily see that they lie on the same line. So that is another reason that we can say that these two are linearly dependent, and this happens in R2. Now on the other hand, if you consider these two vectors, say V1, which is ordered per 2, 3, and V2, which is ordered per 3, 1, then V1 and V2, if you consider these two, they are linearly independent. Now in this result, we are going to prove that any non-empty subset of a set of linearly independent vectors is linearly independent. Subset of linearly independent set of vectors is again linearly independent. Suppose we consider S to be a linearly independent set of vectors in V, and we consider a sub-collection from that S, say T, consisting of V1, V2 and so on Vk, which is a subset of S. Now we consider the linear combination. If we want to show that these are linearly independent, we have to consider the linear combination equated to the additive identity in V. So we have lambda 1 V1 plus lambda 2 V2 and so on lambda k Vk equal to 0. Now we can supply zeros here and replace those zero vectors by 0 into Vk plus 1 and so on, 0 into Vn equal to 0. But V1, V2 and so on up to Vn, they are linearly independent. So the linear combination equated to 0 should give each scalar 0, and therefore lambda I's becomes 0 for all I ranging from 1 to n, including this k. So that shows that the linear combination equated to 0, implying each scalar 0, and therefore these vectors are linearly independent in V over F. So if we have a subset of a linearly independent set of vectors, then that implies that the subset is linearly independent. So that is the result just now we proved, that a subset of a linearly independent set is linearly independent. Now on the other hand, if you consider superset of a linearly independent set of vectors, it may or may not imply that they are linearly independent. No, superset of a linearly independent set may or may not be linearly independent. Now how about linearly dependent set of vectors? So we know that a superset of a linearly dependent set is linearly dependent. So superset, when we consider, okay, and basically if we consider a set which is linearly dependent, and when we consider its superset, then that will be linearly dependent. And again, if we consider a subset of a linearly dependent set, a subset of this is given to be linearly dependent, and we consider a subset of this linearly dependent set of vectors, so what we can conclude? It may or may not be linearly dependent. So these are the some of the statements that we can have from the linearly dependent set of vectors and linearly independent. In the case of linearly independent, subcollection will always be linearly independent. In the case of linearly dependent set, we have superset to be linearly dependent. Their subset, that's in the case of linearly independent, and the case of linearly dependent, its superset will be linearly dependent. So that is the difference between the two.